Good morning, welcome everybody. Thanks for taking the time coming to this session. My name is Jiří Kadlec, and my presentation is together with Pavel Treml from Czech Republic, and we will discuss interpolation, how to make a large number of interpolated maps using R software. In this presentation, we will be dealing with the data that are fields which have dimension in space and also in time. For the observation, we can ask the question what, where, and when, and our values may be regular but also irregular with a lot of missing data points. And here in this slide is the example of data I'm talking about. You can see the columns are station, then longitude and latitude coordinates, then the variable we can see here are two different variables, temperature and snow, then the time when it was observed, and also the value. And with my colleagues we were facing the task, we had hundreds of stations and hundreds of observations per station, and we needed to create maps for all the time steps with the same appearance. So examine how one or more variables change in space and in time. So regarding interpolation, we have some observations, and we want to estimate what was the value at a certain time where we don't have any observation, or as in the second example, we have a location and we want to estimate what was the value at this location based on the surrounding locations, for example. And now I will talk about the R environment. R is a free software for doing statistical analysis. It is open source and runs on Windows, Mac, and Linux operating systems. And in R, there is many input data formats. Your input data may be as a text file, or if you're familiar with vector data, shape files, or with raster data grids. And also it supports a large number of output data formats, including pictures, text file, and also raster and vector. And the main strength, I think, is that R has a scripting language which allows to automate your tasks. So for example, here at the top we have an example script which reads a text file, and then it creates the graph, in this example, the discharge at two different rivers as the time series plot. So in my case study, the case study creates maps of air temperature and snow in Czech Republic, and year is 2013, and also for orientation, we need to show some background features, such as the major rivers and country boundaries. So here our process proceeds as a loop. First we load our data sets, and then for each selected time we locate the matching observations, then run interpolation, create the map cartography, and then move to the next time step. So our first example is showing how we can load a raster dataset in R. So at the start we have the command library. This selects the needed functions, and then we have a local file with the elevation data. Then next we set the color ramp, and last we can plot it on the screen using the color ramp. Also in R there is a useful function which allows you to get the elevation data for your area of interest directly from the web. Then next example is a little more complex. It shows how to load the vector data. By vector I mean country boundaries or rivers. In the first case we directly load the rivers. We are using functions in the map tools package. But in the second example our data set is in a different coordinate system, and we can see R supports the functionality to reproject our vector data to the desired coordinate system. Then last we organize these datasets into a layout, and we can visualize them. Now for the observations which change in time, we have a text file. So using read table command we can read the text file. This text file contains data for all the time step, so we can subset it just to use one time step. And then in the second part of this example script we assign the coordinates, and we can also plot the labels with the point values as shown in the example. Now the next example shows all the different data types displayed together in R. So we have the raster, which is the elevation grid. We have the vector, which is the borders and major rivers, and we have the points, also vector, which are the observation locations. Now moving to interpolation. As you may know, there are many different methods and algorithms for interpolation available. Two examples are IDW, inverse distance weighted, which is called deterministic method, and the second is kriging, which is called the geostatistical method. Krieging compared to IDW also gives you more information about the errors of your prediction. And but often, such as in the case of meteorological data, we have some other information which could help us with our estimate. For instance, temperature is often correlated with the elevation above sea level, and in our case we have the elevation grid available. Therefore, in R we can create a linear regression model. So here A is the intercept, A is the slope, and B is the intercept, and then we can use these coefficients in our next step. So in our next step we can use these coefficients to multiply the values of the original elevation grid and add the intercept to this product, and we get a basic estimate of the temperature. Then, if we look at our regression model, we have some residuals. Those are the blue lines in the slide. So instead of interpolating the original values, we just interpolate the residuals, and then in the last step we combine our grid created by the linear regression also with the residuals. There are also some variations of this method. Here I showed it's called regression Krieging, but also there are universal Krieging, or you can see the name Krieging with external drift. So if we want to show our data in the map, it is important to select the right contrasting color scheme and color breaks. So for this there is a useful package called R-Color Brewer, and it provides us with predefined sets of the color ranging from the high value to the low value. And now if we combine these steps, so we loaded the vector data, we loaded the raster data and our points, and we also set up our predefined color breaks, and we ran the interpolation process. Here is an example which shows the snow depth in the Czech Republic for a selected time step. It's the 1st of January 2013, and we can see the rivers and country borders, and in the bottom part of the map we can see the predefined color ranges, snow depth in centimeters. Now, important step is we want to save our map to a file. So in R you have the option to save to different file formats, such as PNG picture or a PDF file or a vector graphics file, as well as some GIS formats. And the trick there is that first you write the command with format of the file and specify some settings, such as file resolution and image size. This is useful if you need to supply your file for publication. Then you run the plot commands, and then this dev.off that stops the writing to the file. And so now we will move to the bulk interpolation. As I have said, I have multiple time steps. In my case, 365 days, and for each day I need to create the map with the same color scheme and color breaks. So for this we can use a command which is called the for loop. So we start this loop, then inside we run the plotting and interpolation command, and then we repeat this again automatically until the last time step. So here is example for the snow. We can see the first time step and second time step, and each of these has the same color scheme, therefore it's easy to compare how the snow depths changed in the course of the time, with snow melting and new snow falling also. And so, if I could, according to my experience, compare R with desktop GIS, in desktop GIS your maps are highly interactive, and you have good options for label placement, but if you want to automate and create a large number of maps in reproducible way, we found R easier to use. Although the maps are static, not interactive, there is quite good documentation and large user base. Our task can be automated and reproduced, and so we found R to be the preferred method for automatically creating large number of maps. We can also consider, in desktop GIS, typically you have some project file where the process of creating your map is stored. In R, this is stored in the R script. So here is the references. I would recommend this book, Applied Spatial Data Analysis with R, and also the Practical Guide to Geostatistical Mapping. Here are some useful websites. And finally, if you would be interested in trying your examples with your own data, there is the website hydrodata.info/R. On this website you can find this presentation, you can find many different sample scripts which are commented, so you can replace the parts you need with your own data, and also you can find the source data meteorological observation for the Central Europe region. Thank you for your attention.
Space-time creeping rather than just doing individual slices, because there's some packages that can do that now.
Right now, I have looked at the individual slices. I haven't looked at the three-dimensional space-time creeping. It could be interesting option to explore.
Georeferencing your output graphic, your PNG? Is there a function within R or one of the packages to do that?
Basically, our output we can save to different file formats, and so this includes also georeferenced file formats such as the geotiff file, and the functions are in the package called raster package. Yes, so one example to present it is we can save our data to the KML files, and then we can use in WebGIS, for example, Google Maps or Google Earth. So that was one example I looked into. I think there's example script for this in the website I've shown.
Okay.